Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to edit images with the help of Gemini AI API. So I'll be showing you how to do this in JavaScript Node.js. In case if you don't have Node.js installed, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. If you already have it, let's get started. First thing, just Google AI Studio. You'll be having the first link from aistudio.google.com. Just select it and you'll be taken to an interface like this. Here we will be having API documentation. Click that, and in the documentation to the left, under capabilities, we will be having image creation. Select it, and here we are having the Python, Node.js and REST code for generate images. If you scroll down, here we'll be having the image editing with Gemini, and here we are having the Node.js code. So we can just copy this, and this code works well, but it's not in REST API, which means that I can't like send a request from Postman. So I'll be also showing you how you can create an endpoint and basically send your image from Postman, and this will give the edited image of that. So we can just copy this code, and here I'm having an empty folder in my Visual Studio code. I'll just create a new file called new.js and just paste the code over here. And for this, we need to install this particular package, okay, which is google/GenAI. So if you want to know more about that, if you go to the documentation, we'll be having this SDKs, and if you just open it, and here you can see for Python, these are the steps, and for JavaScript, as you can see here, npm install at google.gen.ai. So you can just copy this and open a new terminal and basically just run this. And here we need to add our Gemini AI API key. So to get the API key, go to Google AI Studio's home interface. We will be having the get API key over here. Select it and just select create API key. If you don't have any project, you need to create a project. I have, so I'll just click on create API key in existing project and just copy this. And if you want to delete it, you can just delete it. That's totally up to you. And you need to use this API key in an environment variable, but since this is just a demo, I will just remove this. And within double quotes, I'm just going to paste my API key like this. Now we are good, and this is the code. We are importing the necessary library, putting the API key, and this is going to be the path from which we will be sending our input image. So we are just converting it into a base64 image, and here we are sending the prompt. For example, I'm having an image. In case I want to change the color of that image, I'll be sending the prompt over here. And here base64 image is the image that we are sending, and it's inside contents, both the prompt as well as the image, and we are sending that contents into this particular model, which is Gemini 2.0 Flash Experimental Image Generation. And this model can give both text as well as image in the output response. So this is the response that we are getting, and after that, from the response, we are fetching the image alone, the image data, and after that, we are just writing it in this location. All right, we are writing here. So this is basically the entire code, and this function gets automatically called whenever we run, okay, from this file. Yeah, that's basically it. So now we just need to load the image from our local system. So I will just go and add an image. So I'll just drag and drop this image, yeah, edited image.png, or I'll just rename it to sample.png. And now here, since I'm having it in the same folder as my .js file, I can directly give the name of the file itself, which is sample.png. And in case if you're having it in another folder, you need to give the whole path. All right, so just replace it, and for this I'll just go with a prompt. Can you open the door? Open the door of the car. That's it. This is going to be my prompt because the door is closed now, and let's see what it can give now. At the end, here in the exact same folder, we will be having this Gemini native image.png. This will be the name of our edited output image. So for running this, again, go inside the particular folder in terminal, it's going to be node space new dot js, and hit enter. I've just got this error, Google auth, and the reason is because here they're having this particular key thing, all right? So within this key only we have to specify the environment variable. So I will just copy this and go here and paste that inside this. So it's going to be something like this. I will just remove this, and we need to have this key. API key is going to be the key, and the value is going to be our Gemini, you know, Gemini AI API key. And then here we need to put the curly bracket. So it needs to be something like this. You need to have a curly bracket, API key, and inside that only you need to paste your Gemini API key. Okay, so I will just rerun this now. So as you can see here, I'm getting the console image saved as Gemini native image, and this is the console that we are getting. And the prompt is open the door of the car. So if I go to my output image, as you can see here, the door is opened and doesn't look good, but yeah, still it does the job, you know, what we basically said. And yeah, so now let's see how we can use this particular thing from Postman, like sending the image as well as the prompt from Postman's request, and then processing and sending back the image to Postman again as a response. So now to add REST API endpoint for this code, we'll be requiring two packages. It's going to be Express and Multer. So just run the command npm space I space Express, and it's going to be Multer over here, and hit enter. Multer is basically used to, you know, get the image that we are sending from Postman. So an Express is just to create an endpoint in Node.js. And as usual, we'll be just going and importing it. So it's going to be const Express equal to require, within double quotes, is going to be Express, and we'll be also creating the Express variable, which is const app equal to Express, and we'll be using the express.json app.use. It's going to be express.json. Alright. And now let's also import Multer. So it's going to be const Multer equal to require, same within double quotes, Multer. And basically we'll be also using the storage as well as the upload feature from Multer. So after this app.use, it's going to be const storage equal to Multer dot, we're having the memory storage function from it, so just call this. And next one is going to be const upload equal to Multer, and within circular and curly bracket we're going to just put the text storage inside it like this. And now let's go and create our endpoint. Just come to the next line. We'll be using our Express variable. It's going to be app dot post. We can just have a path over here. We can just have it as edit hyphen image, something like this, comma, and we'll be using the upload, basically this Multer variable dot single. So we're going to upload a single image over here. In case if you want to upload multiple images, you can just configure that. And next one, it's going to be the request comma response. All right, and we'll be having arrow function, curly bracket. And now basically we will be getting the text prompt as well as the image that we are sending from Postman's request. So we need to access that image as well as the text and store it in a variable. So it's going to be const, let me have that as a prompt variable equal to request dot body dot text. And the next line we'll be having the image. It's going to be const, let me have it as image buffer equal to request dot file dot buffer. All right, so it will be in this format. And now what we need to do is, we have got this, now we need to make use of this existing code. So for that, just remove this generate image function. All right, we don't need this anymore, and we just need to like put this entire code inside that. So we can just copy these stuff, all right, and cut this. Can just remove the function and go here and just paste it like this. It's throwing us an error over here, await or allowed inside only async. So you can go up and near this request and response, you can just have the async keyword. Now, as you can see, that error has gone. So now we have to make some modifications here also. For example, here it says load the image from local file system. We are not going to do that. So we can just remove this three lines of code. All right, we can just remove this stuff. And rather than having here image data, we will just put here image buffer like this. All right, and base64, everything is fine over here. And next, rather than having the prompt here hard coded, we can just send the variable like this. All right, so quite simple. Rather than hard coding everything, we will be just making it dynamic in this particular portion, and these are fine. And next thing here is the response. So rather than writing the response into our file system, we need to send that particular image directly into our Postman's response. So for that, we can just remove these two lines. We can just remove write and this console. These two can be removed. We just need the buffer. So it's going to be response. Just have it here, response dot set. It's going to be content type with a capital C, hyphen type with a capital T also. It's going to be part dot inline data, which is this one, and dot mime type. Basically, we are getting the type like PNG, JPG, the type of the image, or you can just have here or condition saying it's going to be image slash PNG, image slash PNG. All right, and next thing we'll be just directly sending the buffer. So it's going to be response dot send the buffer. All right, which is this variable. This has the image. So that's it. Now we are good, and we just need to start the server. So just come to the end. It's going to be app dot listen, and here we need to pass the port number of the server. So it's going to be 3000, and we need to also have a callback function saying console dot log server is running, something like this. All right, with the code, and let's just start it. Yeah, the server is running, and now what we need to do is we need to send a image from Postman. So go to Postman and put a new thing, and this is going to be of type app dot post. So make sure that you're changing the operation to post, and just type http colon double slash localhost colon 3000, and instead of this we need to use our path, which is edit image. Put it over here and go to body. We will be having the form data, select it, and here inside key we will be having this tiny structure. Okay, you can just click here and put a file and just click on the select files. Here you need to select the image. I'll just go with this image and open it. And now we need to give the name of this key. So for that, as you can see here, we are having the name given here as upload.single as image. So basically we need to give the key name as image, okay? If you want to give any name, you have to change that name here also. So I'll just go with image. And next is going to be the prompt. So for prompt, we are having here as text. So I'll just go here and put text, and I'll just go here and ask change the color to black. All right, and send it. Okay, I have got this error, and let me just go and check in the code. So this is the mistake that I've done. So after this upload.single, you need to close the circular bracket. All right, it needs to be something like this, and we can just remove the extra bracket over here. So I guess this is good now. It needs to be something like this, right? This particular bracket should close here itself, and then we are having the, you know, overall bracket for post, which comes till the end. All right, and let's just rerun it. Now it's running, and if I send it, so now as you can see here, we have got the image here as the response, and the car is like black in color. So that's it. We have successfully created an endpoint to get the editor image in the output. I hope you have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. There are a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.